Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Kingdom Maker on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Kingdom Maker and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Kingdom Maker. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all folks, to get started we need to launch our main web browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's go to that URL that I have highlighted in green color. Now, you are able to see on the screen. There is no need to type it because I added a clickable link in the video description and the first pinned comment. We arrived here on our site of Usitility, in which we find here a detailed description on the best way to download and install Kingdom Maker on computer. We browse down a bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we reach the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to the game Kingdom Maker on the PC. It is now obvious that we access some pros of running the emulator. Then, we will proceed to download the Kingdom Maker by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on the button. And the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, here is located the download. It is a file to execute. What we are going to do is to launch the executable file, okay, then we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the laptop or device. We clicked yes. I reduce the browser to see the installation software significantly better. The installer is very easy to use. It consists of a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I will explain what setup path does. We simply click on it. And now we see that we have here the path where in fact the emulator is going to be set up. If we wish to change this folder we are required to click on this browse option, and now we opt for another directory and install the emulator specifically where we desire. I prefer to set it where it is. Then, I click on back. So I click on install. Voila! The installation starts and it is going to commence in the download of these megabytes that happens to be visible on that computer screen. After you save it on your machine, it could be a little bit more or less MB. The data transfer speed will go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, subject to your type of access to the web and depending on the speed capacity of the emulator hosting servers. At the moment they are working rather fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator has been launched successfully. As you can observe, down here, there is a progress bar which will move forward to the right and once it reaches the end, the emulator is started for the very first time. The truth is the emulator has already been launched there for the first time. Before we carry on, as you can see, it has created a couple of software icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be only one we are concerned about. When we need to operate Kingdom Maker on our laptop or computer, we double mouse click on this specific app icon and consequently run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Why don't we do the next step, which is actually a requirement, and this is to access the Google Play Store. And we will click on Play Store. As you can observe the Google Play is launched. Here we are required to log on. At this time when we are on this page, we must definitely execute the next step that is definitely absolutely mandatory. Therefore we mouse click on Sign In. At this moment it says Checking Info. It can once in a while get blocked in Checking Info, that's why it does not move forward. If that's the case, you can try to connect to your account after a couple of hours it's going to probably be fixed. At this moment we are going to enter our username and password. The email address must be a Gmail email as well as its associated password. For instance, you make use of the exact same email you are using at this time in your own YouTube account. Therefore, I will type in my details and I'll go back when I have completed it. That's all, data entered. Discover Google welcoming us and supplying us their terms of service. We are going to consent to them all simply by clicking I agree. Following, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also let it selected and it will create a backup of your files on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We click on accept. Google Play Store is launched by default and completely on its own. To set up the application, we need to go to the emulator desktop for Android by double-clicking on that app icon marked green-colored. Today that we are on the desktop of the emulator for Android, we notice that we find here the install game option. We click or double-click on that button. Right here we have the game. Let's just click now on the install button that I'm presenting now in green color. Therefore it will start the installation. Straight away it would download on your laptop or computer and install the game. It can take a bit of time or it could also be extremely fast. It again all relies upon on our internet access. It's just ended setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking on this option that I'm emphasizing in green, in order to launch Kingdom Maker for the very first time. We're already on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're preparing to just click this new Kingdom Maker software icon which was generated. This game is launched for the first time. So there we end up with it, I can click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the volume of that emulator. It's right here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't rely on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of your emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the fullest, we will switch on the large monitor, for which we have two options. That is the first one, we then click on this particular app icon that I am actually showing in green color. Then the screen is maximized, having one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. Assuming that we want to enjoy the application using all the screen, we hit this icon. And we might already be experiencing and enjoying the Android game in 100% screen mode. To exit the complete screen functionality, click the F11 key. And then we would already play in regular display screen mode. At this moment I am going to show you the computer keys mapping that is certainly very interesting. That step we may be ready to utilize the game application much more easily. The first point is to press this application icon. It's now time to make the recommended controls. I'll go ahead and leave the default settings, though if you wish to improve it, you may very well achieve it without any problem. Clearly, the emulator is completely in our language. Once in a while it occurs that your emulator is launched in the wrong language, such as, in Mandarin. And therefore to set it in the right language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then here within many other controls, we just click the language drop down. We could choose the language we wish, German, Japanese, and so forth. When the language is determined, we should save, the emulator would reboot, along with the Android game, next time we use it, will of course be in the chosen language. At this point, there is another detail that we have to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive a message from Gmail reporting that a different machine has been connected with our Google account. It will definitely ask us if we are the individuals who have connected that electronic device. That's right, we really should not be troubled, considering the fact that emulator is simulating an Google Android tablet or smartphone. In order to see which device is currently being emulated, we go right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. And so we go here to the model option. And now we observe that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for the video user demo. I sincerely hope you appreciated it, especially that you thought it was interesting. In that case, bring it a great thumb up, subscribe to the channel, and any feedback, concerns or ideas, put them in the comment area down below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel, I conduct live streams occasionally, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Mouse click on any of the videos which are usually appearing on the screen and let's have fun again in the next online videos. Bye!